Ubisoft shared some updates on ongoing mysteries in Valhalla, and one quote is from my recent interview, and one is from Darby, who of course recently announced to be leaving Ubisoft sadly. We'll likely talk more about that on the weekly Valhalla podcast. Now this video is more about those Valhalla mysteries, like Skadi's Blade and those weird runes. So we got interesting updates and also replies from Ubisoft. If you like that, then a like on the video would of course really help me out. And let's go. We know about that Tyrannus pack for a really long time now. Will we see it this Tuesday? I will of course be streaming and hope to see you there as well. And if you want a chance to win this armor set, then you can participate in my weekly Helix credit pack giveaway for 2,300 credits. You can enter via the link in the pinned comment, and only subscribers of the channel are able to win. Good luck. Okay, let's start with Skadi's Blade, that amazing frozen axe that we saw in a video from Jonathan. Like, it is already in the files of the game, and Ubisoft even mentioned the weapon in their patch notes. Because they fixed an issue where the perk would remain inactive when conditions are met, and we know that the perk is increased light damage when close to full health, so not bad. And I know some people actually already got a major rune with this perk as well, kind of implying that this weapon should have been in the game already. And I'm happy that we discussed and captured this line from the patch notes mentioning the Skadi's Blade in a recent video, because Ubisoft removed it. If you look at the patch notes now, the mention of Skadi's Blade under balancing and anywhere in the notes is completely gone. So what the heck is going on? We already speculated that because of the sort of bear on the blade, which we can very easily see in Jonathan's footage, the fact that the description talks about Jotun of Winter, and because it's a frozen axe, that Jotunheim seems like a great spot to get it. And we of course have the ice axe in Utgard that looks kind of similar. So, that's of course over here on the map in Jotunheim. And we now see footage from before the update, because what is interesting is that if you go there now, since the latest update, we have way more golden wisps here in the same spot around the axe. Implying that there might be some Jotun magic here, where if you stand in a particular location, you of course reveal a sort of opening. So maybe that is going on here too. And Legolas shared the secret change regarding all the wisps, like, showing up here, but he could not find a way to trigger the Jotun magic, if there is any. Antonio also went to this spot and he did trigger something interesting. Here we see a video he shared via Twitter where he like moved the camera and then the statue, the helm around the axe, disappeared. But then the moment he would like move away from this spot, it would show up again. So it might be like a glitch, it's still pretty strange. And I also went to check on this myself, and I did not use the leap to go down, but just jumped down, and then at one point I was able to walk in the air here, and I could not go down, like, via this tower. And I remember, like, climbing this tower already had the magic going on, but I don't think that this is supposed to happen, right? So, there are some weird things going on in this area, but it's hard to say if it's connected to the Skadi's Blade. And I was able to ask Ubisoft about the weapon and if we should keep looking or if we should wait a bit. Let's do Skadi's Blade. You guys talked about it in the patch notes. You were changing something to this weapon that is that nobody found in the game yet. Can we expect it in the future? Is it already there? Is it hidden? Do we have to look for it?
This is so tempting. You know, I could say that it's hidden just to have you guys look for it. But it's coming in the future. It's not hidden. It is
coming. Okay. Oh, that's good to hear. So this was of course from my interview with Jose, the post-launch producer, and I also got reached out by Michael Walton via Twitter with a quote from someone else at Ubisoft saying the same thing. So it seems like we can stop looking for now, but I still would not be surprised if it had something to do with this location in Jotunheim. Although you could also argue that getting any item during a vision is kind of strange, like we haven't seen any items from the mythical worlds. Although, any reason to visit these mythical worlds again and fight these really fun enemies would be greatly appreciated. Another ongoing mystery that you might have seen discussed on other channels is regarding Odin runes. JV made some videos on it, for example, and the ones who came before also posted a big article putting all the information together and I will leave a link to their content in the video description. So if you aren't aware, all over England there are these runes, these carvings in mountains, in rocks, even one near our settlement over here on the map, so very, very close by. And there's also one in East Anglia, so over here on the map, and you can actually walk over this one. And Lynette Smith reached out via the input at drepta.com email address, so just like you can if you found cool things in Valhalla, with a video showcasing something very interesting, namely that these runes seem to be illusion runes. Because if you use a stone and put it over the runes, then the rune actually appears over the stone, which is very strange. I'm not sure where Lynette got the stone, but we tried it with a body and did not get the same effect. Yes, we carried the body all the way to the rune, so it's rather strange. Right now there are 6 locations found with these runes, and most of them are like on mountains vertically, so you cannot walk over them. And the ones who came before made this map with like lines trying to connect the runes, but nothing yet. And Darby did say a while back, of course the narrative director on Valhalla, that the community was onto something. But now it seems that we have to wait a bit, because Darby very recently now notes that it's a mystery you cannot fully solve yet. That's by design, be patient. So again, another mystery that we have to walk away from for now, but that will have a meaning in the future. And I saw some people speculating that this might be for a mission where we have to go to all these locations. We saw that with the Blind King pre-order mission that then later showed up in the Ubisoft Club section of Odyssey. And I want to thank Ben and Changing Soda in the Discord for helping me remember this. You see footage here from PA, also linked to that in the video description. Like, I would not be surprised if that turned out to be it. There were also 6 sick points we had to go to during that mission. I hope it's not that though. I hope it's more exciting than this. But yeah, we really don't know at this point, and we will just have to wait and see. The fact is though that there's a ton of stuff coming to Valhalla, whether it's conclusions to these mysteries or completely new content. And we of course already know a little bit more. I still got some info from my interviews. We'll be sharing that very, very soon. So totally subscribe if you haven't already to be the first to know about all the new content and stuff coming to Valhalla. A like on this video would of course really help me out. You can watch my big video on the one-handed swords coming to the game. Ubisoft confirmed it by clicking on the screen, or I will link to it at the end of our photo mode showcase that we of course like to do here at the end of every Valhalla video. You can send in your shots via the Valhalla Raptor hashtag on Twitter, or via my dedicated pictures channel on Discord. You can join the Discord via the link in the pinned comment, and be sure you accept the rules, and then you are able to post. Hey Joyce, come in. You selected of course 3 shots from the community. I'm very excited about the last one especially, so let's get into it.
What's up everyone? First up is Jenna over on Twitter, who explored around England finding this interesting looking tree with bodies hanging from the branches. The contrast between the beautiful field of flowers and the death near the tree is pretty creepy, but a great shot nonetheless.
I don't know where this is, but it looks pretty creepy indeed. Very, very cool.
Next up is Too Much Sauce over on Discord, who went creative with, I think, the final strike on the legendary wolf animal. Is it like posing or dancing? It looks perfectly synced, like a statue. Made me laugh.
What? Yeah, is this like a circus act or something?
Yes, exactly. And finally, well, here you have it. We've got one of the horsemen of the apocalypse, it seems, burning all the way. Gordon Lamb took this wide shot of Eivor on its mound while being surrounded by fire. This is a very epic picture, but also kind of painful, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, for sure. It kind of gives me Trojan horse vibes in a way as well. Really, really cool. So thanks everyone, of course, for sharing. Make sure that you share your shots and then maybe you will be in the next video. Subscribe for way more Valhalla content. Check out our previous video on the one-handed swords coming to the game. And for now, we will speak to you next time. Goodbye.
Goodbye.